As Yari mentioned before, there are many different OGC APIs. I think there are even OGC APIs for sometimes types of geospatial data that were not covered by the previous generation of web services. So each one of these APIs provides access to one type of geospatial resource. So to a route, or to a map, or to a style, or to a join, and so on. So if you need to work with one of these geospatial resources, you can choose one of these OGC APIs. Even if we have 2 hours, we don't have time to go through all of this. So we are going to focus on the ones that are more relevant for the GeoE3 project. And these will be OGC API features, OGC API processes, OGC API coverages, OGC API joins, OGC API environmental data retrieval, or EDR, as it's known, and finally, OGC API records. So as you can see, they are in different stages of approval, and I'll show you a roadmap later on. So the ones that have a full solid border, a green border, it means that at least one part, so one or more parts, were already approved. So they are a standard. The other ones are candidate standards. So you can see that even if the OGC APIs are quite recent, some of them are already standard. Some of them have been already one, or in some cases more than one part has been approved.
May I can add some words on that part?
Of course. Before you, yeah.
Go deep ahead. Diving into the different OGC APIs. Joana, you were talking a lot about how the different APIs are evolving, and in that point, Deng said it is organized in a way so that everybody can participate. So that's the organization of OGC is in organized in a way so that we have domain working groups or standardization working groups, and in these working groups the different APIs are being discussed, and the different steps when they are moving forward to be approved are being discussed and decided in this working groups, and you are welcome to join here and participate. And then on the beside that, there are also coding sprints regularly. Well, beside the working groups are meeting always in these OGC member meetings, which are taking place 4 times a year. And then in parallel to that, we have the coding sprints, where the APIs are being, well, specific topics are being then focused on and moved forward. And that's open for everybody to participate. And in this moment, we can say always that you are very welcome. If you're not already doing that, you are welcome to join. Even if you're just one, even if you're just passive, if you're just there listening and observing and learning, so that's also a good contribution.
Just thank you, Nils.
A little advertisement for OGC.
Excellent point. Yeah, and maybe we can pause here and ask if there are any questions before we dive into the OGC APIs. Questions more about this introduction. Okay, no, I guess not. Okay, so let's start the diving. So the OGC APIs give us access to different resources, and they allows us to navigate through this web of connected resources. So what you can see here is that there is a common trunk. So all the OGC APIs start with a landing page, and we're going to see that in a second when we dive into more detail. And all of them, they have the same, maybe I can call it boilerplate. So they all have an API definition, they all have conformance declaration, and most of them have also a collections endpoint, where they list the collection of particular specific type of data that they host. And then you have the difference, the differences from the that vary according to the type of geospatial information that we are accessing. So for instance, if we are accessing features, then we have access to features resource and feature. If we are accessing records, we have access to record and records. If we have, if we are accessing a coverage, then we have other types of resources like domain set, range type, and so on. And then we have processes, which is slightly different because it's accessing processes rather than geospatial information. But you can see here there is a certain coherence behind this, and the idea was to have a common way of thinking through all these APIs, which makes sure that also that when you implement an OGC API or when you study an OGC API, then it will be easier for you to learn a second OGC API or a third OGC API, because they always follow more or less this kind of common structure. But we're going to see that now with when we enter with more detail into each one of the APIs, we're going to have the opportunity